Today, we're going to be creating this cool tennis ball in Blender. To start off, I'll press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm going to choose UV Sphere. In the bottom left-hand corner, you'll notice there's a little menu here, so I'll just left-click to open it. Here where it says Segments and Rings, if you're using this to make a game asset, you might want to keep this low, but for us, since we're just doing a nice render, I'm just going to left-click and drag down, and that's going to allow me to edit both of them at the same time, and I'll just type in the number 64. There, now we have a nice smooth ball. Then, I'm going to rotate it. So I'm going to press R, and then Y, and then 90. Now rotate it 90 degrees, on this green line here, which is the Y axis. Next up, I'm going to press Tab to go into edit mode. And what we want to do is we want to select this top half of our ball and rotate it so it lines up 90 degrees to the right. So the first thing I'll need to do is select the top half. To do that, I'm going to come up to here and you can see there's this toggle X-ray button. If I turn that on, that'll mean when I make a selection using Box Select, for example, which I just use left click and drag to do, and I rotate around, you can see it's selected through the object. I'm going to left click this button here to go into my orthographic view, just this red X symbol on our axis. I'm also going to press free on the keyboard to go into face select mode, and I'm going to left click and drag to box select all these. And now if I want to keep selecting more, I'll hold down shift and then left click and drag, and that's going to allow me to box select more things. For the middle bit here, you might want to zoom in and just try and patch up what we haven't got selected. And the top bit will be nice and easy. We can just shift and left click and drag, and we can get all of that selected. I'll turn off my x-ray. As I mentioned, we're going to want to rotate this, but if I was to rotate this now, since it's still connected, it's going to cause issues, as you can see. So first we need to separate these. So with my selection, I'm going to right click and then I'm going to choose separate and then choose selection. Unfortunately, when you do this, it does put it into another object, but that's okay. We can join them back up together and they'll still be separated. So press tab and that's going to take us out of edit mode. Then I'm going to left click my top half here and shift left click my bottom half and press control J to make them the same object again. Although I've joined these together, I haven't connected them together, so they're still separate. So if you want to select one half, all you need to do is press L and that's going to select a linked object. Since all these faces are linked and connected together, L will select this top half only. You then press RZ, and then I'm going to type in the number 90 to rotate it 90 degrees. What Z does is the up and down axis, so I'm just moving it along this blue line, as represented here on this axis symbol. Now you can see we've got a kind of pattern of a tennis ball appearing, a curve that goes down and round to the back. But we need to join these up again. So to do that, I can just press A, and that's going to select everything. So think of it as A for all. Then I'll press M for merge, and I'm going to choose by distance. I'm going to open up this little box here, and make sure this number is set to 0.0001. If you make it too big, it might accidentally merge things which we don't want to merge. To double check, I'm just going to zoom in and make sure nothing's been merged, but that looks perfectly fine to me. If I now left click one of these faces and press G, you can see everything's now connected again. And if we press L, it's going to select the whole thing, since everything's linked. The reason why that was able to merge was because these vertices were overlapping each other, meaning even though the merge distance was really small, because they're overlapping each other, they're so close that there is no problem joining them together. Now we want to select where we want our tennis band to be. So this is the really easy step. Again, I'm going to make sure I'm in face select mode here, or you can press free on the keyboard, and I'm going to use alt left click to select one of these loops. Since this seems a bit thin, I might select two of them. So maybe I'll press alt left click here to select this one, and shift alt left click, which is going to allow you to select another loop on this one here. But you can select any loops you want. And then I'm going to want to extrude them inward, since there's going to be a bit of an indentation. So to do that, I can press alt E, and then choose extrude faces along normals. And I'll pull it in like that. You can see I've maybe pulled it in a little bit too far, so I can open up this extrude region and shrink menu and just increase the offset. About there should do nicely. If I press tab to go back into object mode, you can see we've got our indentation, but our object isn't looking very smooth. So to fix that, I can just press right click and I'm going to choose shade smooth. You can see that causes some issues around here though. To fix that, all I'm going to do is left click this blue spanner here and press add modifier, normals, and then choose smooth by angle. And now that should fix the issue. Next up, we're going to want to smooth these edges because right now a tennis ball wouldn't have such a hard transition. So I'll press 2 and that's going to allow me to select edges instead of faces in edit mode. I'll then press alt left click to select this edge loop here and then shift alt left click to select all of these edges here. Then I can press control B and that's going to enable the bevel command. And I'll maybe just make a small bevel like here. Here in the bevel menu, you can open this up and you can change the segment's amount. So I can maybe change this to 2 or 3 to make it a bit smoother. Keep in mind though, the higher poly you make this, the longer the render times. And now we have a much smoother transition on our tennis ball. Some of you might want to do the inside bit as well, like this edge here, but I'm just going to leave it just now. To add some materials, I'm going to go ahead and left click this red and black checkered ball here, and I'm going to press plus new. Right now, if I change my base color here to a green color, you can see there's no change. change. And that's because we need to go into material preview, which is this button here. Now we can see the color that we've made. I'm going to change this color to a bit more of a lime green, like this. And if you want to tweak it later, you can. I'm going to double click this material here, and I'm going to call it lime green ball. Then I'll press the plus button, press plus new, and this material I'm going to call white ball. Then I'm going to press tab to go into edit mode, and press free on the keyboard to go into face select mode. And essentially what we're going to do now is we're going to select all the faces which we want the white ball material for. To do that, I'll just press alt left click on this face loop here, then shift alt left click on this face loop here. Then I can just press assign, tab to go back into object mode, and now you can see we have the white bit of our ball. The next step, we're going to be adding some particle systems to create a kind of fluffy effect. I will mention as well is to do with this material here. You can see we've got this parameter called roughness, and that's really the only other one you need to worry about besides color. Roughness doesn't mean like a bumpy surface, but rather it refers to the clarity of reflections. So if I was to turn this to zero, for example, it would make it super reflective, like a really shiny non-metal surface. So I personally wouldn't make this any lower than 0.5, since the fur is going to make this quite a rough surface reflection wise. So you can maybe go for a number like 0.5 or 0.6, or maybe even a little higher. Also, I'm going to left click this blue spanner again, and I'm going to change this angle to 60 since the bevel wasn't smoothing properly. So that's something extra you can do. We first need to create some vertex groups, which are going to tell the particle which areas are going to be white and which areas are going to be green. So to do that, I'm going to left click this green triangle, and where it says vertex groups, I'm just going to press the plus button. I'm going to double click this group and call it green. Then I'm going to press tab to go into edit mode, left click away to deselect everything. I'm going to left click this red and black checkered ball, left click the green material here, and you can see there's a button called select. That allows us to select everything that is included in this material. I found that the last faces here sometimes cause some issues. So for me personally, I'm going to press free on the keyboard to go into face select mode. I'm going to press shift alt, and I'm going to left click this loop here to deselect it. And I'll do the same for the opposite loop. Shift alt, and then left click. Now I have all the faces I need selected for the green group. I'm going to left click the green triangle again, and then press assign. Now when I press this deselect button, you'll notice everything is now deselected, and I can press select again. That's now going to select the green group we made. Next, I'll press this plus button, and I'm going to call this group white by double clicking it and just typing in white. Come back to my red and black checkered ball called material properties menu. I'm going to left click the white ball material and choose select. Come back to the green triangle and press assign. Then I'm going to press deselect and then select to make sure it's working. Looks like it's working just fine. I'll press tab to go back into object mode, and finally we can get started with the particles. The particle menu is this symbol which looks like a few branches coming out of a single point. I'm just going to left click it and press plus to add particle system. You can see we've got two options, emitter or hair, and we're going to choose hair. Right now our hair is a little bit too long, so I'm going to change it to a hair length of 0.015. Now you can see that's much shorter and more kind of what we're needing. Segments as well, you can change to 3. The reason why I'm even using a number of segments is just in case you want to use the particle edit later, which allows you to create more adjustments. If you don't want to bother with that, and to be honest, I didn't end up using it in my final render, you can just set this to 1 to save a little bit more render time. For the number, I'm going to leave it at 1000, and you might think this is nowhere near enough, but what we're going to do is scroll down to this children menu and change it to interpolate. And you can see that's added a bunch of hairs in between each hair randomly, which creates a nice bit of variation, and it also adds more hairs. I'm going to change the display amount from 10 to 500. You can see I've done this for the viewport display amount and the render display amount, so I can see what it'll look like in my final render. You can see though, it's added a bunch of green hairs over our white area. The first reason for that, if I scroll up, is that where it says render, you can see the material here is selected as lime green ball. This is fine though, because we're going to use a separate particle system for the white area. So I'm going to leave that as it is, and I'm going to scroll down to the bottom, and here we have something called vertex groups. Remember the thing we made earlier? That was also called a vertex group. So that means we can use a vertex group to control these different options. The only one we need to worry about is density. So I'll left click this empty box, and I'm going to choose green. You can see after doing that, the white area has disappeared. Now I'm going to scroll up to the top, and I'm going to press plus again. I'll change this to hair, and I'm going to change the hair length to 0.015. I'll change my segments down to 3 in case I want to do particle edits. Again, you can turn this to 1 if you don't want to bother with that. Since the white area is smaller, we don't need as high a number. So I can just change this number to 300 or something lower like that. And of course, I'll scroll down, and where it says material under render, I'm going to change that to white ball. Again, if you can't see this menu, it's probably closed. So it'll look something like this, and you can just left click it to open it. At the bottom here, where it says density, I'm going to choose white. You can see all the hairs are now appearing in the white area. I'm going to turn children to interpolated, and I'm going to change the number to 150. for both of them. Now you can see we've got plenty of fluff on the white area of our ball as well. I'll also scroll up to the top, and I'm going to name these particle systems to keep more organized. So this second one we made here was for the white area, so I'll call it white fluff, and I'll call the top one green fluff. Awesome. Now we've finished, all you need to do now is add some lighting. I just ended up using a simple HDRI. Set one up is super simple. I'm just going to press this X button to get rid of our world. Press plus new, then where it says color, I'll left click the yellow dot, left click environment texture. Now you can download an HDRI from a site called Polyhaven, which is the one I usually use. You get both EXR and HDR files. I'll then press this open button, and in my file view here in downloads, I'm just going to search for the one I want. So I just searched for EXR to filter by only EXR HDRIs here, and I'll just double click this metal one. Now when I left click this button here to go into render preview, now we can see our tennis ball come to life. If you want to know how I got transparent background here, I just went to my render property settings, went down to fill, and then turned on this transparent button here. If you want to learn how to render an image, you can check out this video here. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.